Hi guys, today I'm filming this grungy, structured, roundy eye makeup look. This was requested. I had posted it on my Snapchat and I had said you can either have like this look or this look. So the first look was like really natural, faux freckles, bald lip, paired back eye, strong brow, and that's kind of the first look. And then the second look was this. Pavram, it was using like loads of sunset-y colours, so like yellow, orange, pink. But I decided that I wanted to do a little bit more grungy today, so I switched up the colours a little bit. But I have chopped my hair off. So I only have my short little hair now, and it's taking some getting used to, but I'm getting there. Without further ado, let's jump on into this tutorial, and I hope that you enjoy it. Starting off with my Urban Decay eyeshadow primer potion in the shade Eden, I'm using the applicator and just popping this all over the lid. With this flat illusion brush from Charles Fox, I'm just popping that all over the lid, packing it on the same way I would select Cover Up by MAC. Using Illamasqua Hype now, I absolutely love these shadows. They're so nice. They blend really nicely. They're super velvety. I'm just applying these with the Smith brush at the moment, and I'm just mapping out the shape that I want. Because this is going to be really rounded, I want to kind of alter the shape of my natural eye. So I'm mapping out the rounded shape, and then I'm not worried about the blend just yet. So I'm just making sure that I have that color intensity really strong. And now I'm starting to use small circular motions to blend that. So I find this is a good trick, especially because this is going to be a really structured look. I want this to stay rounded. I'm really concentrating on the shape that I'm creating. Going in with this mustard colour from the Venus Lime Crime 2 palette, and this is the shade Mustard. Very original, I know. I'm basically laying down these colours the exact same way, but the darker the colour, the smaller the brush. So I've gone to a smaller brush now, which is going to focus in a smaller area, but it's still going to be above that crease, so when you're looking straight ahead, none of your work is going to be lost. Going back in then with my previous brush, which I used Hype with, and I'm just again using those small circular motions to blend out the work. Just checking myself out, you know. Going in with Mud now, again from that Venus Lime Crime palette, and again I'm working just above my natural crease, but I don't want to go too far down towards the crease, because I still, when I'm looking straight ahead and after I carve out my lid, I still want to be able to see the work that I've done and laid down. So again, I'm just laying down the colour, building up its intensity, and then later on I'm going in and I'm blending that with my small circular motions. Just remember, every time you lay down an eyeshadow, you want to go back in with your previous color. So I call these, you know, sandwich stages, or whatever you want to call them. So I'm just constantly going back and forth between the colors that I've used. Now using the Inglot Under Eye Concealer in the shade 95, I'm using my Illusion brush from Charles Fox. And what I'm doing here is I'm just looking straight ahead, pressing into the top of the crease where I've done my first mark, and then my second mark is in towards the inner corner, and I'm just feeling the ball of the eye and I'm following around the natural crease. So what I do to start off my carve is I follow around the natural crease. I get that basic semicircle shape done first using the tip of the brush. That it's really going to help me, the shape of this brush, and the fact that it's really dense and sharp as well, create a really clean semicircle. So what I do is I get that basic shape and then I start gradually building it. So you'll see now that I'm starting to build up that shape to match the opposite eye.
So what I'm doing here is it's kind of like a drag technique. I'm basically making an illusion of a deeper set eye and a bigger lid space, which I don't have, but I want it to look like I do when I look straight ahead and also when I have my eyes closed. Using Mud then from the Venus Lime Crime palette again, I'm going in with the same brush that I used previously and I'm just mapping out a diagonal shape, and this is basically going to be a guideline for me to know where I should lay down my black liner later on. I'm also going in with that mustard shade and I'm laying it just in front of where I laid that mud. And then once I've laid that down, I'm going back in with mud. So it's constantly with these sandwich stages. So what I'm doing is I'm going in with the Stargazer pigment, and I can't remember the number of this, but I'm using a similar shaped brush to the illusion brush I was using previously. And this is basically going to help me cut really deep into the crease there and follow that line and have it really clean and structured. So once I have that laid down, I'm going back in with my previous colours, which is the mustard and the mud, and that's just going to help my gradient be really clean and nice. Using this Ben Nye glitter glue that the lovely Jeanette Cronin sent me from her new shop, and I'm laying that down in like the hook around the eye. So I'm laying down the glue first and then I'm going to go in with the glitter. You can use any really thin precision brush for this. So the glitter that I'm using is Pastel Yellow Disco from Glitter Express. I get these usually at the beauty show, but I know Jeanette also stocks them in her shop. And I'm just laying that on top of the glue that I laid down previously. And I'm not swiping, I'm packing this on. And if you feel the need to, like if you feel like the glue towards the end is starting to dry up, just wipe that brush clean, go back in with your glue, and then lay down that glitter all over again. I also find that this glue is great to seal in the glitter if you find that it's not like staying well, but I haven't had an issue with it personally. So I'm just going in with any old cheap eyeliner here, and as you can see, I'm literally just mapping out that shape. And then I'm just filling it in, and I'm not worried too much about the roughness along the edges, as I'm gonna sort that out. And with my Push Black is Black, which is the most amazing black eyeshadow I've ever found. So I'm just packing that on, and again, I'm going in with the mud then, I'm just packing that on to help keep that blend. Our Red Cherry Lashes, and these are in the number 102, and I just pop those on with some duo glue. Going in then with my Kat Von D Locket Concealer, and this is LN5, and I'm just blending that out with a blending brush. And I kind of take off the excess of the concealer from the blending brush, and then I work it into the eye shape to make sure that I keep that nice and rounded. I want to make sure that my blend is really rounded. Going in with the under eye then, I'm going in straight ahead with Hype, and that's going to start as my transition colour. And then again, I'm working backwards to the colours that I used on the top of the eye. So what comes up must come down. So I go in with my Hype, then I go in with my Mustard, then I'm going in with Mud. Now I'm going in with that Black is Black, and I'm just pressing that in just along the lash line there and then blending it back out with Mud. With a little bit more concealer, and I'm using this crayon brush, and I'm just making sure that that's blended. I am popping this Copperized by Push Makeup into the waterline as well. I love these pencils. They're like gel consistency on the eye, so they don't budge whatsoever. So now I'm going in with my Tattoo Liner by Kat Von D, and I always like to do this step once my lashes are on. So basically what I'm doing is I'm just cleaning up that line and making sure it's really sharp, and that diagonal when I look straight ahead and when I look down is really cut. So I just use the Tattoo Liner for that because I feel like it doesn't hit off anything. And that then is the eyes. All done. Now for skin. I'm going in with my Illamasqua Skin Base, which is my holy grail of a foundation. And I'm using the Buff and Blend Skin Focus Sponge, and I'm using the butt of it. And I am loving this. Like, I never thought I'd say that about a beauty blender, but I am. Like, are you able for that coverage? Oh my God. I'm using the point of it and I'm just going around the eyes. For the top then, I'm going in with this Buff and Blend brush. I can't remember the number of it, but I'll put it down below anyway. And I'm just working that into my forehead in tapping motions. Going in with the Estee Edit Bare's bronzer, which I am loving. It's such a perfect bronzer shade. And this FXMA, like, I think it's a powder brush, but I use it for foundation and bronzer. And I'm just hooking that bronzer around the hook of my cheek as well, and that's just going to give my cheeks a little lift. To bake then, I'm going in with this RCMA No Colour Powder and back in with that Skin Focus sponge from Buff and Blend. And I'm just starting to kind of sharpen the edges of my cheekbones there to make them look more structured. And I want them snatched up to the gods. Oh yeah. Just pressing that in to blend it out. And then I'm going to go in with my bronzer and just soften that all over again. Using Lime Crime Teddy Bear. I absolutely love these Velveteens. They last so well. And I'm just doing my lips. I'd usually use a liner, but I couldn't find one that would be suitable like with this color, so I just went on in. This is from the Mauron blush palette. I can't remember the name of this actual color, but I'm just using the same bronzer brush. This is a beautiful highlight. Like, you can see that glow. It's so gorgeous. And it is from Pro Artist from Freedom Makeup.
So guys, this is the finished look. I hope that you all enjoyed watching this tutorial. Maybe you learned something new or different. If you recreate this, or if you are inspired by this look and create something inspired by it, please tag me in all your posts on Instagram, hashtag BelleMakeupArtist. If you don't already, please follow me over there, which is Belle_MakeupArtist. I'll put that here on the screen. So yeah, I hope that you enjoyed this. Sorry if you're being kind of MIA and my videos being sparse, but I'm going to get back on it, I promise you, or come at you with like a whole load of videos. So if you have any requests at all, let me know and pop them down in the description or in the comment box below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do, and make sure you click that little bell button to make sure that you get notified of every upload. And yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Thank you guys. Bye.